Good evening, and welcome to the East Noble Theater Senior Night Celebration. Now, ideally, we would be starting our Saturday night production of The Addams Family right now at this time. But unfortunately, due to the COVID-19 pandemic, that's not happening. But because the class of 2020 means so much to East Noble Theater, to the East Noble Theater staff, and to myself, we wanted to make sure that the class of 2020 was being recognized. So with the help of alumni, the Community Learning Center, the East Noble Theater staff, and so much more, we are going to do this virtual celebration. Now, I'm sure you noticed that I'm not standing on the Monk stage right now. Well, there's two reasons for that. Reason one is that the Cole Auditorium is currently getting a makeover right now. A beautiful paint job is happening, and I cannot wait for our students to come back and see it. I can't wait for our patrons and, of course, our alumni to see the wonderful job that East Noble has done at taking care of the Cole Auditorium. Two, it was 50 years ago tonight, in 1970, that the cast of How to Succeed was celebrating the very first East Noble Theater Senior Night. Now, before we get started with anything, we are giving away a couple of scholarships. The first scholarship that we're giving away is the Gaslight Playhouse Performing Arts Scholarship. And to present that, I have Gaslight Playhouse President Kim McCutcheon right on the other line to present that.
Hello, my name is Kim McCutcheon, and I'm the current president of Gaslight Playhouse. Very honored to be able to announce this year's recipient of our Gaslight Playhouse Scholarship for 2020. I would first like to say thank you to all of the applicants as you contributed to the arts and theater over the years, and you made our decision very challenging this year. I would like to say that the person who won this year has been a four-year member of the East Noble Theater, East Noble Show Choir as well for 4 years, and also a two-year member of the marching band. And she is also a member of the Children's Theater Workshop for 2 years, 2 summers, with Gaslight Playhouse, and a member of the cast for Rodgers and Hammerstein's musical review 2 summers ago. She will be attending Purdue Fort Wayne this fall and majoring in music therapy. And at this time, I'd like to congratulate Sadie Coverstone on winning this year's $500 Gaslight Playhouse Scholarship. Congratulations to the entire class of 2020. You've had a challenging year. I know that you all be stronger because of it, and we wish you all the very best of luck. So congratulations again to Sadie and the class of 2020 from Gaslight Playhouse. Thanks.
Hey, congratulations, Sadie, and thank you so much for presenting that tonight, Kim. The next scholarship that we are about to give is an East Noble Theater Senior Night Tradition. It's the Patrick E. Bruce Memorial Scholarship. Here to present that, all the way from Texas, is Gina Bruce Dowd and Laura Bruce Spadoni.
Hi everybody, Laura Bruce Spadoni.
And Gina Bruce Dowd. We're coming to you from Plano, Texas, in front of the Doyle Dean Performing Arts Center on Plano Senior High School's campus.
40 years ago tonight, Patrick and I were on the stage for our senior night.
And so we decided to do something super special for the class of 2020 Patrick E. Bruce Memorial Scholarship winner.
We hope that you'll enjoy this next video and feel the love tonight.
Peace out, class of 2020. We love you.
Hey, class of 2020. I'm L. Stephen Taylor, and I play Mufasa in The Lion King on Broadway. And it's my distinct honor to be able to announce virtually the recipient of the Patrick E. Bruce Memorial Scholarship for 2020. Now, part of the application process is an essay. So before we get started, I just want to read a few words from our recipient. They say, perseverance is often defined as doing something despite the difficulty in achieving success. It's the building block of a successful career in the performing arts industry, the tenacity and the drive that you must keep going. Having a strong sense of perseverance has been paramount in my growth as a person. I have had numerous health challenges my 15 years of dancing. At age 5, I was diagnosed with a brain tumor. Going through chemotherapy and dancing wasn't easy. I was constantly sick, and there was a point where I couldn't walk. I've also had to endure many surgeries related to my tumor, several when I was younger and 2 during my high school career. These surgeries have kept me out of dance and have made me work that much harder to get back to doing what I love. My strength in persevering for my future will shine, however, in the biggest challenge a performing artist faces, limited job prospects in the industry. By going to college, I am also ensuring that I have a solid foundation of key skills and quality education in a dance career. This is something that I can take into any future as an artist, whether it leads me to the stages of Broadway or into the classroom as a dance instructor. I've dreamed of pursuing a performing arts degree my entire life. So on behalf of the family of Patrick E. Bruce, the recipient of the 2020 Patrick E. Bruce Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Michaela Frazier. Congratulations, and congratulations to all of you guys. I know that you guys were supposed to be doing your spring musical right now. I'm sending you lots of love. We're all in the same boat, and I hope that soon we can all get back to doing the things that we love.
Wow, what an amazing presentation. Thank you so much, Gina, Laura, and Steven. And congratulations, Michaela. For those of you that don't know, the Patrick Bruce Scholarship is a great East Noble Theater tradition, and you know, I happen to be one of the recipients myself, and I know how much it can help a young student going into college, and I'm just very excited. Thank you so much again, Gina, Laura, and Steven. One of the things that makes East Noble Theater so special is our alumni. We have a wonderful group of alumni dating back all the way from the class of 1967 to the class of 2019. All of them are so supportive of you, of me, of this entire East Noble Theater program that we are all a part of. You will find that there are East Noble Theater alumni all over the world that have kept a little piece of East Noble Theater inside their heart. Here to welcome the class of 2020 into the East Noble Theater alumni family are some members of the East Noble Theater alumni.
Hey, East Noble Theater 2020 graduates. I'm Brooke Campbell. I graduated in 2013, and I just want to say all of my favorite memories involved East Noble Theater when I was in high school, from theater arts class to stagecraft to, of course, the amazing musical and plays that are put on at that school. It really allowed me to step out of my comfort zone and to develop my skills as a performer. And it's really the reason why I'm still performing today. I'm a singer and dancer with Carnival Cruise Line Entertainment, and I owe so much of that to my time with East Noble Theater. So I hope you guys all had an amazing 4 years at the school, whether that means that theater is something you see in your future or whether it's simply an outlet for your own creativity and just something fun to do. I'm sorry that your time was cut short, but stay strong and be proud to be part of the East Noble Theater family and alumni for life. Congratulations, graduates!
Hello, East Noble class of 2020. This is Ed Davis, class of 1970. How to Succeed in Business was the only show I ever did in high school. And standing on that stage closing night and watching them light the ghost light was one of the neatest experiences I ever had. It kind of meant to me that I was leaving that light on and that stage lit for future productions, yours included. And unfortunately, yours is not going to take place. But while none of you seniors will have that moment on stage, you will have something none of any of the past senior classes have. When East Noble Theater alumni meet for the 55th alumni celebration to meet old and new friends, you seniors will have your own hold my Mountain Dew and listen to this story moment that no one before you and hopefully no one after you will be able to tell. By the way, closing night was not the end of my theater experiences, only the beginning. So be prepared for life's ups and downs. Take care of yourself and keep the lights lit. See you at 55.
Hello, East Noble Theater graduating seniors. Congratulations. My name is Erin Taylor, and I'm a 1981 graduate of East Noble and was a big part of the theater department. And I know how very special this night is for you. And I just wanted to let you know that 40 years later, the East Noble Theater experience, the light, the people, the friendships, the love, the experiences, the memories are still a huge part of my life. And I know that standing on the stage tonight, I remember standing on that stage and looking around and thinking, oh, this is the end. And how am I going to go out in the world and be out in the world without these people and this family and this love? And I'm here to tell you that 40 years later, it's still with me. And some of the people are still with me, and the memories and the experiences have shaped my life. And I also wanted to let you know too, don't ever lose your passion for this work. Whether you go into this professionally or not, carry this passion, this creative passion, this desire, this hope, possibility, this fearlessness with you. And you're gonna be a huge success. Don't ever lose sight of that feeling. I remember standing there and thinking, I have the whole world ahead of me and I am gonna conquer the world. And if you carry the passion and this love with you, you're gonna conquer the world and you're gonna be a huge success no matter what you do. And I'm so excited for you. Huge congratulations and many, many blessings.
Hey guys, Michael Baranda, class of 1997 here. I just wanted to wish you guys a happy senior night. For the occasion, I decided to bust out this sweet hat that I wore in Joseph, a bit of a shout out to Mr. Ogle. Actually, I don't think that he probably wore this hat. I think they did away with this sweet part of the wardrobe for the show, notwithstanding how amazing these bedazzled stones are. I actually kind of hated the hat, but quite frankly, brings back a lot of memories from that show, and you know, that's why I stole it, so I could have something to remember it by. But again, guys, I am truly sorry that you guys have to experience your senior night like this. I was looking forward to, like I do every year, seeing you guys. It's a great tradition. But if there's any solace that you can take out of all this, is that certainly for me, some of the best memories that I have with East Noble are with the reunion shows. And so I can guarantee you that 2020, when you guys come back, class of 2020 is going to have some memories and things to celebrate when you guys have your reunion. Talk to you soon.
Theater class of 2020, Lisa Reasoner Hall, EN class of 78 here, coming to you from Evening Twilight in social distancing Florida. I'm honored to be able to welcome you all to our elite EN Theater Alumni Club. If you were involved 4 years ago, you may have met me at the 50th anniversary show. I was one of the divas. Well, this night is certainly not the same, or what you may have hoped. Here's hoping that we can all help you celebrate at next year's anniversary show. I can tell you, I have never missed one at all. I was there for the very first one that was just a short performance after George M. Senior Night. Oh, however, over the years, they've grown to be extravaganzas, and it's always a thrill to come back for those. I always meet new alumni, like your teacher, Mr. Ogle. Before that show, 4 years ago, I didn't know him, but now I consider him a friend. I'm thrilled to see he's picked up the torch and is running with it, and you students are his exact shining example of that. I'm going to sign off now. I wish you huge congratulations and hope to see you in 2021 at the 55th East Noble Theater Anniversary Show. So long. Have a great night.
What's up, class of 2020 thespians? Hey, my name's Jonathan Kane. I was a part of the 2014 East Noble Theater class, and theater was a huge part of my life in high school, and it's one of the main reasons I'm out here in LA now pursuing the entertainment industry in Hollywood. But I just wanted to make a quick video to let you guys know how excited I am for you. Congratulations on completing 4 years of theater, your high school careers. You should feel immensely proud. I'm sure there was sleepless nights and a lot of stress, but you made it through and you should feel great about that. I'm sorry that this virus got in the way of your senior night, but hopefully you feel really loved and supported through these videos. And the best part is now you're an East Noble Theater alumni, which means that when we meet during an anniversary show, I'm gonna be able to share some stories with you about your teacher, Mr. Ogle, that I definitely can't repeat on camera now. But congratulations again, guys, and enjoy your summer, and I'm excited for what life has in store for you now.
Thank you for that one, Jonathan. Wouldn't it be just a shame if your anniversary show invite just disappeared in the mail? No, I'm only kidding. Thank you so much to all of those East Noble Theater alumni. We will be hearing from more of them later on in the evening. Now, back to the light ceremony. Like I said, it goes all the way back to 1970, and there's a lot of history behind the light ceremony that has happened with East Noble Theater for 50 years. Here to talk to us a little bit about that history is the man, the myth, the legend himself, Mr. Craig Monk.
Well, Josh, I cannot take credit for the idea, okay? I'll take credit for 48 years of it, but the whole idea I stole from Wagon Wheel Playhouse. My wife and I went to Wagon Wheel Playhouse on the final night of one of their seasons, and they did a similar ceremony than we have here, but I was so caught up in that when everyone was saying goodbye to each other and leaving, that they may never work together, they may never see each other together, because it's summer stock theater, and they had been a family for that summer, but now they were leaving. And for some reason, that just really, really hit me hard. Maybe the idea that I also was leaving at that point, I was headed off to Ball State and leaving my girlfriend back here in Kendallville. But anyway, that's where it got started, and I put it in the back of my mind, and I said someday we'll do it, and we did. You asked earlier this week, where did the light actually come from? Well, our ghost light here at East Noble is not a real ghost light. It is a fabricated hall tree from downstairs from this exact theater, and I remember putting it all together, and it is the same light. Now, I know some people won't believe that we have kept track of it for 50 years. It is the same light that we started with 50 years ago.
Wow. Did you ever, how did the ceremony or the tradition change over the years? Has it been the exact same thing from 1970 all the way up until?
I thought it had been very similar. I'm learning this week that it was not. That the first time, I don't think it was quite as elaborate. I'm not even sure if I talked about the seniors. And then I think over the years it stayed pretty much the same. Talk to the seniors, light the light, say goodbye to the freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and then a special goodbye to the seniors. It's always been on Saturday night of a production, which doesn't make it super final because there's always been a Sunday show. So instead of a farewell goodbye ceremony, it was more, it turned into a recognition of the seniors, really.
And then the light became a big part of the anniversary shows as well.
Right, right. So the light has been lit more than 50 times because we do light it every 5 years at the anniversary show. And I think when you light that light for that, all kind of memories keep come flooding back about, wow, I remember the night they lit the light for me, or I'm standing on stage of a freshman looking up to seniors and remember the night they lit that. You know, Josh, the light has been lit a couple few other times. One night I left the theater and looked up, and there the light was on top of the theater, on the roof, shining bright, and I do know those culprits. I do know who did that.
Do you think they're watching right now? Or
one of them might be, because he does a lot of theater in Fort Wayne.
Oh, well, hey.
And that's another little story. I am just shocked that every year we could find it. It kind of, as you know, it has its own little closet at East Noble, but I said, if I ever opened that door and couldn't find it, then I would panic. You know, like, oh no. Or the whole idea that it wouldn't light. And we found that out earlier today, that we went to light it and the wires were broke. And Mr. Seibel came to our rescue and got us all working again and everything. But you ask about, has it changed? Not really. Has the meaning changed? I don't think so. I think when it first happens to you as a senior, it's just kind of, whoa, this is my final night, these are my theater friends. Then as you look back, then it kind of triggers all kind of memories as far as, and you might be able to answer that better than I. For me, it's almost 52 years, I can't even figure that out. 50, yeah, so it would be, I guess about 50 years of memories for me too. What about you? What do you remember your senior night?
Yeah, I think I remember joking around with you about something.
Wanting my job?
No, I have no idea any of that would ever happen. I think for me it definitely meant when you finally say, keep that little piece of East Noble Theater in your heart. Obviously, for me, I kept a bigger piece in my heart than what maybe some of the other alumni.
Because you have a big heart.
That
kind of has become a stock thing. Keep a little bit of East Noble Theater in your heart. And I think you're finding that out. You do a fabulous job with the alumni, as we're seeing here in this program tonight, that you've connected so well with the alumni, and all of you have kept a little bit of East Noble Theater in your heart.
I think so. Well, I guess my final question for you is, did you ever think 50 years ago that you'd be sitting in this very theater 50 years later filming a virtual senior night because there was a global pandemic going on?
No. When we left here in 1981, ironically, right during that time, I think Karen had some problems and she was in the hospital. So I'm not sure, a couple of those senior nights, or one of those I might have missed. But anyway, and who would have thought that they would have restored this beautiful, beautiful theater? It's almost ready to open and get going, and we're so excited. And I know both you and I have worked hard on making this all happen, and it's just the beginning. So how special, 50 years later, to return to this theater for the 50th anniversary of Lighting the Light on this very stage.
Right. I agree. Thank you, Mr. Monk.
Oh, thank you, Josh.
Such an amazing history of the senior night tradition here with East Noble Theater. I think you and I, Mr. Monk, could probably take a show on the road. Let's get together and talk about that once this pandemic's over. All right, up next we have a very special message from two people that mean a lot to this program, and that is our music director, Mr. Chris Metter, and our evening of theater director, Mr. Darren Seibel.
Class of 2020 seniors, this is Mr. Metter, your musical theater director. Just wanted to say a couple things. Thank you, first of all, for 4 wonderful years. We've been together for a long time. We've done a lot of really great shows together. Thinking back to when we started with Sound of Music, all the way up to your last show, which we knew didn't know was going to be the last show, but turned out really great, was White Christmas this year. I just want to thank you all for your talents, for helping the theater continue to thrive in Kendallville and in the East Noble community. And I just want to wish you well on your way. I know that you're all going on to do wonderful, wonderful things, and just hope the very best for all of you. It's been an awesome ride. Thank you for sticking with this for 4 years. Thank you for joining, and best wishes to you as you graduate. Goodbye.
Hello, class of 2020. You know, you all are a really special class to me. You know, you were the first, you know, you were the class that, you know, those of you who were at Northside I worked with when I was still in high school. You're the class that I started with when I taught here. You know, almost all that I taught was your class, you know, when I first came to East Noble a few years ago. And it's exciting to see you all come up and come through this knowing what I've always known about you. Your resilience, your ability to take what's in front of you and to work through it and to make it better is what's, you know, gotten you through this time period and what's going to really keep you guys going in the future. I love this time of year. I look forward to the light, doing the lighting the light for the seniors every year. You know, ever since I had the light lit for me 8 years ago and the first time I was part of it when I was a freshman back in 2009. And, you know, that memory of knowing that what we have on this stage isn't permanent. It's going to all go away. You know, the scenery is going to get struck and the costumes will be put away and the photos will be put into an album or saved on Facebook or whatever. But knowing that no matter what, those memories are all always going to be there and they'll always be part of you. And so even though this year hasn't gone as we planned, we didn't do all the shows we were supposed to, things didn't go the way we ever thought they would, all of those memories are part of you and they really show how strong and how independent and how great all of you are. And I'm really excited to see what all of you do in your future.
Hey, thank you so much, Mr. Seibel and Mr. Meddert. You guys mean a great deal to this program. Thank you so much for all you do for East Noble Theater. At this time, we have more East Noble Theater alumni who want to welcome the new decade of East Noble Theater thespians into the alumni family.
My name is Jim Jansen. 49 years ago, I was a senior theater person at East Noble High School, actually in this very auditorium that you're seeing right now. I will tell you that I loved being in theater. It was very important to me. But I didn't quite realize how important it was going to be. Mostly I was backstage and also working on the sets, loving it. But I was forced by my Mr. Ogle to perform. I didn't want to do it. But I put on a French chef's hat in the first edition of East Noble's Hello Dolly, and my line was, "Oui, oui." And imagine my surprise a few weeks later at senior awards night when I was named East Noble's Male Thespian of the Year. What I gained through my theater years, I realized many, many years later how important theater was in helping me have some life goals, to go out and meet people, to be able to have a strong business and professional career. And actually, it taught me how to perform my life. Very, very cool. But again, it's about you right now and the fact that you cannot have part of this experience at the end of your senior year. And you can't just hang with your friends. That's most unfortunate. But on this senior night, I want you to know that my heart and my thoughts are with you all, and I'm sure they are also on the hearts and minds of all the other East Noble Theater alumni.
Hey, class of 2020, this is Liz Frick. I'm now Liz Klein. I got married in January, but it was previously Liz Frick when I graduated from East Noble High School in 2009. So I'm from the class of 2009. I was in theater for all 4 years of my high school experience. I absolutely loved it. I was also a dancer at TC Dance since I was four. So I mostly danced throughout my time in the theater department as well. And it was so much fun. I absolutely loved dancing and performing and being a part of the community there in Kendallville. After high school, I went on to Ball State University and majored in dance for 2 years and then switched majors to advertising. And that advertising major took me all the way to Washington, D.C., where I've lived now for almost 7 years, which is crazy. In my time in D.C., I've done a lot. I pursued my passion of wanting to get more involved and hone in on my skills in technology as well as advertising. And I'm actually working at a startup now, which is a really cool experience, something definitely new. And I'm learning a lot there. And I've also danced on two professional dance teams here. So I spent 4 seasons with the Washington Wizards, the NBA team here in DC. And then I'm finishing up my first year with the Washington Redskins, the NFL team. So my advice for you is don't give up just because it seems like a lot and not everybody does that. Not everybody has a full-time job and is a professional cheerleader by night. It doesn't mean you can't go for it. If you enjoy something, if you enjoy performing, dancing, singing, costuming, lighting, like it doesn't matter what it is. If you have a passion for something that you've learned throughout your time in East Noble Theater or just in high school in general, keep pursuing it. You can do it all. You can do it both. And I believe in you and good luck out there. Bye.
Hello from New York. This is Rick Criswell. I'm a 1983 graduate of East Noble. And I was involved actually in the theater program there all throughout my high school career. The theater was a safe haven for me. Had so many great friends throughout high school there, and still to this day, a lot of friends, great friends, lifelong friends, you know, it was 40 years ago, actually, that I did my first show there at East Noble Theater, and I was going through a box of things I was trying to clean here at the house this last weekend, and I come across, I think I've saved every program from the time that I was in high school. I've got the opening of Cole Auditorium right here, the Music Man right there, and a funny thing happened on the forum right there. So, I mean, it doesn't leave you. East Noble Theater doesn't leave you. And, you know, just really tonight, just embrace and love the moment you're having on that stage. I was the president of the East Noble Thespian Troupe 1106 my senior year in 1983, and it was such a special time. Senior night was a special night. It was great. There were tears shed. There was lots of laughter as well. And you know, the great thing about being a part of this and being a part of East Noble Theater really is later on in life, no matter what you do, whether you become doctors, lawyers, you know, moms, dads, you know, whatever, and you choose to, or maybe to go into the theater, the arts, you know, this will always stick with you. It's shaped you, it's formed you, and just really embrace it all. Embrace it as your time goes, and just really enjoy it. And you know what? I just want to welcome you all to the part we're all brothers and sisters now in the theater. Welcome to the alumni, and look forward to seeing all of you hopefully this next year as we all get together again and celebrate our time together and the one thing that we all have in common, East Noble Theater. Congratulations, everybody.
Congratulations, East Noble Theater Class of 2020. I know this isn't exactly how you imagined your final quarter of senior year to be, but now's the time to remember all of the awesome and wonderful things you did in the theater program. I still carry those memories with me 11 years later, from riding the rotating stage for the first time in Les Mis to spending an entire act in a giant metal tree for Seussical. I even terrorized Mr. Ogle a little bit when I played Captain Hook and he played little brother Michael in Peter Pan. My East Noble Theater friends are some of my dearest friends to this day, so be sure to keep them close to your heart, no matter where your journeys may lead you. Thank you for keeping the East Noble Theater spirit alive, and congratulations once again.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm so excited for you. I'm really sorry your class got cut short. My name is Macy Birch, and I graduated in 2016. High school was so much fun for me, and I'm excited to be back in the community and working here. I went to St. Francis and continued my theater career throughout college. I wish you the best of luck, and don't be afraid to continue your theater passions throughout your life, and be sure to come back to us.
Congratulations, 2020 East Noble graduates. I'm Tom Combs, and I graduated in 1968. By the way, that was the second class to graduate from East Noble. During my time in high school, I was the president of the drama and the thespian club, and I was involved in several musicals and plays. I'd like to share with you an experience of a close friend who graduated from East Noble many years ago. He was involved in the theater, was involved in the music, and while in high school, he started the Changing Seasons. He ended up getting a scholarship in music at Indiana State, and after 2 years in college, he lost the deferment and ended up going into the Air National Guard. During that time, he ended up going back to college and at the age of 20, gave his first lecture at IU Purdue. Worked for one of the top 100 corporations in the United States, was involved in radio announcing, advertising appearances. He did public speaking and also developed a working ability with 5 different languages. At 38, he bought his first company and retired 5 years ago at the age of 65. 4 years ago, he did an audition for Universal Studios and has had numerous requests to do commercials. Almost forgot to tell you that he is dyslexic and spent much of his childhood without a mother. His claim to success has been, one, he's blessed, two, the theater, and three, the military. Today, he's substitute teaching, he's writing a book, and hopefully within the next 2 years, he will have a degree in psychology. Just to end this narrative, we're all in this storm together, but we're not in the same boat. I challenge you to not give up until we meet again, my friends. Wish you well, and have a good life.
Wow, thank you so much, Tom, and thank you to all of the alumni who contributed videos. I cannot wait for all of us to be together in June of 2021 for East Noble Theater 55. That is going to be the biggest bash we have ever had, and I'm looking forward to it. We have one more person who wants to give you a message right from Broadway. Please help me welcome Arbender Robinson.
Hello, hello, hello. My name is Arbender Robinson. I am a professional actor here in New York City, primarily working on Broadway shows that I've done. Hairspray, Hair, The Little Mermaid, Beautiful, the Carol King musical, Ragtime, Les Miserables, Shuffle Along, Lion King, In Transit, and I'm currently in the Book of Mormon right now on Broadway. And I wanted to take a moment out of my day to congratulate all of you and thank all of you for all the hard work that you've put in over the years and the work that you actually put in on what would have been your spring musical this year. So I understand that it's not going to be able to happen, but we still wanted to celebrate the accomplishments that you made. We still wanted to be able to celebrate the fact that you were cast to do the show. And for those of us that work in the professional world, that happens all the time because there are teams of us that are hired to do the workshops and the readings and the labs, but not necessarily do the show. So the work that you've done, the fact that you booked the gig and you started some rehearsals, that process is also something that will happen all the time if you decide to do this as a professional career. So I just want to take a moment out of my day to congratulate all of you and thank all of you and send you all positive energy and joy for my world. And if I were to rewind a number of years, I was in the same place that you all are. The only difference is I wasn't very confident in my talents and my skills, but I worked really hard and I made it to Broadway and have been on Broadway now for 17 years and have been in 11 different Broadway shows and a number of them original. So if I can do it, you can do it. Just keep working, keep trying, put yourself out there and know that all things are possible. All right. Thank you guys so much. Enjoy your day. Thanks.
At this time, we'd like to take a moment to honor the contributions that the Class of 2020 has given to East Noble Theater.
Special memory, and I can't.
Well, guys, there's only one thing left to do, and that's light the ghost light. This light represents so much. It represents the friendships made, the memories made, the blood, sweat, and tears that are put on the East Noble stage. Guys, we've had a lot of wonderful, wonderful times together. And let me tell you, the good times for you are just beginning. You all have such bright futures ahead of you, and I look forward to following each and every single one of you along on your journeys. Please remember that my door is always open, and you're always welcome to come back to East Noble Theater. My final thoughts to each and every one of you are, no matter where you go in this world, or what you do in this lifetime, always keep a little piece of East Noble Theater inside your heart. Good night.